given a point O in a plane and a positive number R, the set of points in a plane that are a distance of R units from O is called a circle. So point O is called the center of the circle, and the distance R is called the radius of the circle. We can see from this circle that OM equals OA is equal to OB equals R represent the radius of the circle. So a radius is any line segment joining a point on the circle and the center of the circle. For example, the radius OA is the line segment that joins point A and center O of the circle. Similarly, M is a point on the circle and OM is the radius that joins the center O and the point M on the circle. The diameter of the circle is twice the radius. For this circle, we can see that the diameter AB equals D when AB equals OA plus OB, and we can get that OA equals OB is equal to OM equals R as the radius. So D equals OA plus OB equals R plus R, which results in twice R. So we can write that the diameter of the circle equals 2 times the radius. And two circles with equal radii are called congruent circles. Chord of circle. Any line segment joining two points on the circle is called a chord. For example, PQ and AB are the two chords of the circle, where PQ is the line segment joining the two points P and Q on the circle, while AB is another line segment that joins two points A and B on the circle. We can see that AB is not only a chord but also a diameter, because AB goes through the center of the circle. But PQ is only a chord which is not going through the center of the circle. Secant of circle. In geometry, a secant of a curve is the line that intersects the curve, for example, circle, in at least two distinct points. For example, in the case of any circle, a secant will intersect the circle in exactly two points. For this circle, the secant GH intersects the circle into two points P and Q. When PQ is a chord, as it is the line segment determined by the two points of intersection on the circle. Circumference of circle. The distance around the circle is called the circumference of the circle, which is analogous to the perimeter of a polygon. The ratio of circumference to diameter is equal to pi, which is approximated to 22 divided by 7 equals approximately 3.14. So we can write that circumference equals pi times d is equal to 2 times pi times r, because we know that diameter is equal to 2 times the radius. For this circle, it is given that the diameter AB equals 6 cm. So d equals 6 cm. That is why r equals half of d, or r is equal to half of 6. So the Therefore, the radius equals 3 cm, which helps us to get the circumference of the circle. Therefore, the circumference of the circle equals 2 times pi times 3, as the radius equals 3 cm. So the circumference of the circle equals 6 pi centimeter. Arc of circle. Given any two points on a circle, an arc is the part of the circle containing two points A and C and all points between them. All points between them. The two points on the circle are always the endpoints of two arcs. For example, as we consider the two points A and C for the arc, so we can see that A and C create two arcs, ABC and ADC. So an arc is frequently identified by three points to avoid ambiguity. And we can see that A and C create two arcs, one of which is a minor or shorter arc, which is ABC. And ABC can create an acute angle in the center of the circle. That is why the major arc ADC can create a reflex angle with respect to the center of the circle. A central angle of a circle is an angle with its vertex at the center of the circle, and its sides are the radii of the circle. The measure of an arc is the measure of its central angle. For example, for this circle, the central angle AOC equals 30 degrees. So the measure of arc ABC is 30 degrees. Where the two radii that connect the center O, the center of the circle, to the endpoints of the arc. For this circle, the center O is connected to the arc ABC through the endpoints A and C, while OA and OC are the radii of the circle. And an entire circle is considered to be an arc with measured 360 degrees. As the endpoints of this arc ABC create two arcs, and here the minor arc has a measure of 30 degrees, and the entire circle is considered to be an arc with measure 360 degrees. So the major arc created by the endpoints A and C, which is ADC, has a measure of 360 degrees minus 30 degrees, which results in 330 degrees. Length of an arc. The ratio of length of an arc to the circumference is equal to the ratio of the degree measure of an arc to 360 degrees. For this circle, the degree measure of arc ABC is equal to 30 degrees, so X equals 30 degrees. So length of arc ABC divided by the circumference 2 pi r, here the radius r equals 3 centimeters, so 2 pi 3 equals the degree measure of arc ABC is equal to 30 degrees, so 30 over 360 degrees, which results in the length of arc ABC equals 1 divided by 12 multiplies 6 pi is equal to pi by 2 centimeters. As the minor arc has a measure of 30 degrees, so the major arc ADC has a measure of 330 degrees. And this measure helps us to get the length of arc ADC, which is equal to 330 degree divided by 360 degree multiplies 6 pi, which results in 11 pi by 2 centimeter. And if we sum these two lengths of the arc, the major and minor arc, we can get the circumference of the circle, which results in 2 pi r equals 6 pi, where r equals 3 centimeter. Thanks for watching. Persevere, practice. Do not forget to like, subscribe, and share. Thanking you from Higher Study Prep.